Yo, what is up, YouTube? It is Legend. Welcome back to another PlayStation 5 and PlayStation 4 jailbreak news information video here on the channel. Make sure I leave a like, comment down below on what y'all think about this, and let's go ahead and break this down. I did do a video talking about how we have a kernel exploit available on 12.02 and 12.60. So I just wanted to come out here and make an update video so you guys can understand what's going on. If you are on the PlayStation 5 and you are on firmware 1.0, or you're all the way on 7.61, and you guys can see on this graph what exploits are available that can be used. That way you can jailbreak that firmware and what progress has been made. If you want to jailbreak your console, you're going to need debug settings. You're going to need ETA hen, K stuff. If you want to, you know, put games on a USB stick and put them on your PlayStation 5 on your jailbroken console, you're going to need these things and these programs to be updated and supported for these firmwares. The good thing is that Lua works all the way up until 11.20, but we just don't have a kernel exploit to use to chain with it. I'd rather have a WebKit exploit because that will work out a lot more better. But we got Pepe Cobain making a tweet of him showing off 10.20. Remote code execution, ROP chain simulation, race condition testing, no jailbreak, no kernel, pure sandbox research. So I guess a lot of people out there are trying to, you know, research this bug and making sure that these two kernel exploits are working perfectly fine and seeing where things aren't working. So that's what a lot of devs are doing right now. They're trying to make sure that they can get this to work. That way we can get a jailbreak, we can install K stuff, ETA hen, and a bunch of other programs out there. If you already have a jailbreak on the PlayStation 5 and you guys already have K stuff, you already know how that works because you guys can get free games and all that good stuff. But I'm seeing here he's just trying to make sure that the exploits are running perfectly fine on 10.20. And you guys can see on the left side of the screen, if it says it's been executed successfully, then the exploit is completely working. What happens if you want to test this out for yourself? I would say you would need to be on a specific firmware that supports these two kernel exploits. That way you can, you know, test out your own proof of concept and show it to the world like you're seeing right here. But you need Lua loader. You will need it. All right. So let's go ahead and move on to the next thing, because I do have a ton of information that I want you guys to hear about. But a lot of you guys out there are panicking that these two kernel exploits won't work on 10.60. There needs to be more testing done for it to work on 10.60, because a lot of people are wondering, is it going to work on 10.60? And Pepe Cobain said, I mean, someone knows about my work. It can be good or not. It's a proof of concept. Yes, it seems to work on 10.20, so I think it will on 10.60 too, but there needs to be more testing. But to break this all down, we've had two new kernel exploit bugs in the last couple of days, according to Justice League Forever. UAF, which works up to 10.40 on PS5, and Double Free works up to 10.60 and 12.50 on PS4. UAF bug by Andy the Flow is up to 10.40 or maybe 10.60, as he says here. Double Free bug by ABC is 12.02 for PS4, and PS5 is up to 10.0. But he says here, based on the proof of concept test, it seems that Double Free has been patched on PS5's firmware 10.20 or 10.40, but we aren't sure and needs to be more testing to be confirmed. Which I do agree. I hope it works on 10.20 and 40 and 60. Just a lot more testing has to be done, guys. Now, moving on, we got Jose on Twitter. A couple of days ago, he made this tweet saying, note that some people ship with 10.01 firmware PS5s. These PS5s also seem to patch the AIO multi-delete exploit. So 10.01 is technically the firmware where this got patched and not 10.20. And then moving on, he ends up saying this. AIO multi-delete has been tested by numerous sources and, according to PS4 people, yes, it has been effectively patched on 12.50. However, on PS5, it has been patched much earlier than that. On 10.20, this means that the exploit works until 12.02 on PS4 and 10.0 on PS5. And he also goes on to say, this means the Flow's recently reported bug is the best option for people on 10.20 and 10.40. People on 10.60 will have to wait. Right now, there's no kernel exploit for that firmware. There is a remote possibility that the Flow's bug works on 10.60, but I'll need to confirm with Key's friends first, or someone needs to do a quick proof of concept in Lua to test this bug. So just cross your fingers and hope that the Flow's recently reported bug is working on 10.60. I also seen a clip going around on Twitter of this PlayStation 5 console on 10.60, and he's using Lua to do a proof of concept here. Let's just hope and pray that this works. I saw this earlier, I think 2 days ago. I had seen this clip of this person using the remote Lua loader doing this on the PlayStation 5 on 10.60. I guess he's trying to get the proof of concept and show everyone that it does work or not. And you guys can see it says double free has failed on 10.60. How disappointing can it be? I don't know what's going on. Hopefully this gets fixed in the future some way or somehow that this bug is actually supported. But I'm going to show you what it looks like on PlayStation 4 using the remote Lua loader. You're on PS4, you're on 12.02, and you guys can see in the upper left hand corner it says double free has been achieved, and that is what we need for 10.60 on the PS5. I recommend anyone that's using a PS4 stay on 12.02 or lower. If you're on PS5, stay on 10.0. if you're lower than that, stay where you're at. Do not update. Okay, wait till more testing is done. If you're on 10.20, 10.40, or 10.60, don't panic, just stay where you're at. Also in good news, we also have Stretch Eco. He released his homebrew enabler payload for the PlayStation 4 firmware of 7.0 all the way up until 11.52. So that's also a good thing as well. And he said here all the payloads are ready for 11.52. This is what we will be able to do if we had these two new kernel exploits. With Lua, we will be able to do everything that you're seeing on this list. Just got to get everything updated. We got K stuff, Gold Hen, ETA Hen. All that stuff has to be updated for these new firmwares with these two kernel exploits. And everything will be good at that point, but it will take time. There still has to be testing done. So just pray for the best. If you're on 10.60, do not update. Just stay where you're at and just hope for the best. I'm going to catch you on the next video. Make sure you leave a like, comment down below, and I'll catch you on the next one. Make sure y'all subscribe if you're new to the channel. Peace out. I'll be back with more news if it comes out. Bye.